morning again, and once again, welcome to the 2016 Forest Park Business Recognition Breakfast. At this time, I'd like to introduce our Master of Ceremonies, local TV 12 weekend anchor and health and medical reporter, Liz Bonus. Liz, last year she wouldn't let us read the intro because she didn't want us to know much about her, but we wanted to say Liz first began working with Local 12 in January of 2002 and is now the anchor for Good Morning Cincinnati on Saturday mornings. She is also the health and medical reporter for Local 12 and other stations across the country. Liz has been a reporter for more than 10 years, beginning first in radio before bringing her talent to television. Liz is also a registered dietitian, certified personnel trainer, and diabetes educator. She also publishes a monthly health and wellness newsletter, has a personal fitness video called The Lazy Way to Lighten Up, it's for women, and writes weekly health articles on Lighten Up with Liz.com. She holds a bachelor's degree from the College of Applied Science at the Rochester Institute of Technology and a master's of Applied Science in Public Communication and Radio and Television News from the Neuhaus School of Public Communication at Syracuse University. In her spare time, Liz hosts nationwide seminars on fitness, stress management, diabetes breakthroughs, weight loss, women's health, and nutrition. She is also active in her community with the American Heart Association, the Juvenile Diabetes Research Foundation, the American Cancer Society, and Crossroads Community Church in Oakley. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce our MC for this morning, Liz Bonus. Liz?
I'm always kind of embarrassed when they do that full thing and you're sitting there having breakfast, but I want to tell you that if you eat it for a good cause, the calories don't count, okay? So have seconds if you wish. How about this new venue? Isn't it wonderful? Nice work, Jax. You know, I was working with them to pull this together, and we have this community relations manager, and, you know, she kind of trusts our judgment. She's like, do you want to do this event? I'm like, yeah, this is a really fun bunch. She's like, because I think they're having breakfast in a tavern. And I said, fun bunch. 5 o'clock somewhere, baby. Well, I want to thank you for asking me back again. I know that I was talking to Bill, the owner here, and he said they fill up a lot of times when there's Bengals playoffs games. Oh, and I have to tell you, the jokes have already started. We were all working that Saturday night, feeling your pain. And as a single girl, I'm allowed to tell this joke. You know, what's the best thing about dating a single girl who's a Bengals fan? She's in it for the long haul and she never expects a ring. Gotta say it. That's my safe one. Okay, I can tell that one. All right, well, for those of you I don't know, I got that great introduction, but really I'm just here with the privilege today of serving this community and of honoring so many of you who show up every day and are, what we say in our business, part of the solution and not part of the problem. You know, we cover a lot of news that unfortunately doesn't highlight the best in our community. So it's a privilege to kind of come together with all of you who get up every day and even when it's snowy outside, come out and try to make the best of your own community. So it's quite an honor today to introduce your wonderful mayor. He's one of my favorite people. He sat down and today, this is the kind of mayor you want. I said, so what do you think of the venue? He says, well, whatever they want to do, I'm game. That's the kind of mayor you want. If you don't know him, let me just tell you a little bit about him. He is sort of the person who is overlooking many of these people who are accomplished here in Forest Park in the business community. And he's here today to say a special thank you to you as well. In addition to bringing up the mayor, I also want to take 1 second before he comes up and just ask you to stand. If I call your name, we'd like to recognize you for just a moment. If you'll hold your applause, we'll get all the people here to give you a big recognition. Charles Johnson is our mayor, but Wendell Burns is our first vice mayor. Denise Holtz, our second vice mayor. Regina Collins, Sheila Cottle, Diana Herbie, Charles Southall, and Ray Hodges, the city manager. If you would just all stand for a moment, could we recognize you here as we bring our wonderful mayor to the stage? Ladies and gentlemen, Charles Johnson.
Thank Thank you, Liz. Good morning, and welcome to the 2016 Business Recognition Breakfast. This is the city's way of saying thank you to you and to the employees for helping to maintain Forest Park as a great place to live. There were certainly increases in our economic development activities this year. Local companies invested almost $30 million in projects involving retention and creation of nearly 1,000 new jobs. Redevelopment continues to be one of our great efforts. In 2015, more than a dozen vacant and undeveloped properties were converted to community assets. In our continuing effort to reinvest itself, the city leveraged a small portion of its funding in conjunction with state and federal funds to complete a multi-million dollar road improvement project at Northland Boulevard. The city partnered with the Port Authority, Duke Energy, the City of Fairfield, and Ready Cincinnati to complete an important study for the Winton-Gilmore interchange. In spite of these impressive accomplishments, we're not satisfied. Challenges remain, and we're going to continue to work together, and then we can conquer these obstacles and help companies, including yours, to find lasting success in Forest Park. Our entire team understands and appreciates the sacrifices that you've made when you invested in our community. So on behalf of the City Council and the administration and all of the citizens of Forest Park, again, we want to thank you for being in Forest Park, and we hope that you will stay in Forest Park for the next 100 years, at least that much. And hopefully, by the end of that time, we will be able to have a Super Bowl banner somewhere in this area. Again, thank you. We appreciate you being here. We hope you enjoyed your breakfast. And we want to give thanks to Jax for having us here and for the wonderful job they've done in preparing this for us. Again, Forest Park would not be Forest Park without these businesses, without you, without your employees, and all that you do for all of us in our city. Thank you, thank you, and thank you.
Thank you so much, Mayor. It's my privilege now to bring up a young woman that just had a chance to get to know through doing some of your awards. Many of you are familiar with her work because she's been involved with these awards for a couple of years. She's going to recognize some special chamber awards here. And I really just, when I think of her and the conversations I've had with her, I really just think of her as a woman of grace. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Nancy Goins.
Thanks, Liz. That's kind of nice. Nancy, Grace, Liz, Bonus, Nancy, Grace. Okay, I won't go there. Thanks, Liz. Before proceeding with our awards, I'd like to recognize those business leaders who volunteer their time and serve on the board of directors of the Chamber. I am the president of the Chamber this year. I've been off and on the president of the chamber for a few years, so I'd like to recognize those people, and if they could please stand. I think they're throughout the audience. Dave Aronson, who is not here, I know. Kevin Jordan, second vice president. Dan Prickle, who's our treasurer. Chris Anderson with the City of Forest Park. Paul Brehm with the City of Forest Park. Sheila Cottle, who's a council member. Kyle Himes with Sam's Club, John Kirtley with Emeritus, Christina Murray with Home Depot, Ken O'Brien with Xavier University, and Dave Zenny with Libby's Gourmet Desserts. So all of these people helped plan many activities, including monthly luncheons, meetings, our golf outing, and without their help, the Chamber would not be able to provide the outstanding services our members enjoy. So please join me with a round of applause to thank these business leaders. I'm very excited to present the two awards to our chamber members this morning. The two winners that we have similar attributes, and it's fitting that we can award them at the same time for their contributions to this community. We're very lucky to have these two winners within our, as members of the Forest Park Chamber. Unfortunately, due to some scheduling conflicts, our first award recipient was unable to join us this morning. But her business is Kingdom Family Dentistry. She's been a valued partner of the Chamber and the community for a number of years. Dr. Monica Swope and her team have continually teamed with the Chamber for important endeavors. Our annual golf outing raises a significant portion of our yearly budget and enables the Chamber to offer scholarship funds for graduating students of the Winton Woods High School. Our scholarship has some unique attributes as it benefits students who do not attend traditional four-year programs. Dr. Swope and Kingdom have been the dinner, event, and/or title sponsor of the golf outing since 2008, which is an amazing partner with the any organization. Their support has enabled the Chamber to expand the scholarship program and offer a program to reach member companies, family members, as well as employees of chamber companies. Kingdom Family Dentistry's commitment to the community is one that should be a model for other companies as we look forward to future partnerships. And we will present Dr. Swope with this award at a chamber meeting and later in the year as well, so when she can join us. So I'd like to acknowledge, though, that Dr. Swope and Kingdom Family Dentistry is the Business Member of the Year. So I'd like to ask Paul Brehm to assist me in presenting our second award. Where is he? He's hiding. And the awards this year are really cool. So, and we're very excited about them because they're made by a company here in town, and we'll be talking about them later, correct? But Paul, can you hold it up? Because he is like Vanna White. He's always wanted to be her. Look at his nails. They're incredible. They're much better than mine.
Thank you, Nancy.
And so these awards were manufactured by a company in Forest Park. And what? So our second awardee is what I refer to as a rising star in the community and in the chamber. She's been an active member of the community for numerous years, and she just keeps on getting better. Christina Murray of the Home Depot rises to the occasion even when she isn't approached. She has a motto of get her done. In her short tenure on the board of the chamber, she's made significant impacts, always asking, what can she do? Please give me a project. Please give me something to do. Whenever there's a need, she's there to fill it. In addition to her volunteerism as the chamber, she's also made other community projects a priority. Whether it's helping renovate parks or partnering with the fire department, Christina Murray gets it done. She has an amazing team that works with her at the Home Depot as well. I'm happy to present the 2015 Chamber Member of the Year Award to Christina Murray. Congratulations. Congratulations. Would you like to say a few words?
Yeah.
You're in.
Thank you so much. I'm honored to receive this award. I've had the opportunity to work with several different organizations as well as participate in quite a few different community events here in Forest Park, and I can't wait to do so again in 2016. Thank you, guys.
And at this time, I'd like to turn the microphone back to the professional, Liz. Thank you.
How about it for Nancy? I wasn't kidding. She's such a gracious person, isn't she? She has this spirit that kind of draws people to her. Well, it's a privilege right now to walk you through the next set of awards, and I in no way want to rush this process, but I do have to tell you that I'm sort of the time police here. So when someone gives me a guide, I try and keep it on time, okay? But that means that when I start talking a little bit about your company or things like that, if you sort of make your way up here, that would be helpful so that there's not this silence where we need someone to jump up and down and scream and holler and get excited for you. Okay? That's the way it works here. We're going to start with our 2016 Business Recognitions Awards, as they're known. And our first award is really a wonderful story. It's an example of the American dream, you might say. 1965, This place opened its doors on Northland Boulevard. 50 years later, the diner still serving a popular menu of traditional family favorites, many of you know them, entrees, soups, desserts. The owner, and I'm going to say the name wrong, but I believe it's Georgi Pavlovsky, started working at the diner alongside his brother in 1971 and eventually bought the restaurant in 1985. His family has worked there ever since. They provide a unique combination of great food and great service to very loyal customers. You are invited, as a part of this event, to always stop in and congratulate them. Apparently, Georgie and Lisa couldn't join us today because they're working. Don't you love people like that? But we wanted to make sure that someone received their awards. Congratulations to the Pavlovsky family. Best wishes for many years. This award goes to the Forest Park Restaurant. Now I'm going to bring up the rest of the A team to help us present the awards for those of you that I know are here today. We want to bring up our Mayor Johnson, again, our city managers, Ray Hodges, the EDC chairman, Ed Statnick. All of you, if you would just come forward and help us present these awards with me, that would be great. Our next award goes to what we know as an independent materials testing company. It was founded in 1971 and specializes in measuring the mechanical, physical, and thermal properties of solid structural materials for aerospace, energy, transportation, automotive, marine, and consumer products industries. In other words, these are the smart people here today. In 2015, this company invested $6 million to improve its Forest Park campus, adding 22,000 square feet to a building and installing 14 new testing stations. They have made a significant investment. Its long-range plans are still in the works. They've purchased another 7 acres of land at Carillon Park, bringing its total footprint here in Forest Park to more than 14 acres. This investment guarantees that this company will be a member of our business community for many years to come. From Cincinnati Testing Laboratories, please welcome Vice President Dave Elbin.
Okay, I'll say a few words. We're quite thrilled to be in Forest Park. It's 45 years that our business has been located in Forest Park. It relocated there from Woodlawn in 1965. I joined the company when it was on Northern Boulevard in 1999. At that time, we had 27 employees. We were doing about $2 million in revenue a year. We just finished up 2015. We've got 65 employees, and we're right around the $10 million revenue mark. Very proud of our growth. And Forest Park really helps us. The location is ideal. We get a lot of, it's an international company, so we get a lot of traffic from the airports, both from Dayton and CVG. It's kind of central between those airports. We already have 3 visits scheduled from some Japanese companies who are visiting us in the next few weeks. We have visitors from Europe, England, Germany, France quite often. So it is a global business. This area is an ideal location. There's plenty of hotel rooms and nice places to eat. So it's we're a service business. So we do a lot of business meetings, a lot of entertaining and so forth. It's an ideal location, and it also gives us access with our growth and hiring a lot of new technicians, machinists. The location is ideal, drawing from the tri-state area, so we're hiring the area's most talented workers as well. So, thank you.
Nice work. Congratulations. Thank you very much. Our next business is quite unique in that it invested more than $500,000 to acquire and renovate a vacant building in the Kemper Meadow Business Center. It converted that empty space into a vibrant art studio and gallery. This company is expecting exciting public places and access to its facility because it devotes an awful lot to creating and promoting glass art. It is the only what they call hot glass studio open to the public in Greater Cincinnati. Their artists offer custom glass design services and educational instruction, and they create design pieces of art for sale. As you might have guessed, they also helped design today's awards and were designed and created especially for this, these winning companies here today with an incredible artist. I'm gonna let them tell you a little bit more about them. I'd be remiss if I didn't mention their impressive commitment to the community, however. This nonprofit organization offers training and education programs to people throughout the region, including a number of activities for students from Winton Woods High School. They are a wonderful and unique addition to the Forest Park business community. Here for NeoSoul Glassworks is Board Chairman Brian Redden.
Thank you, Liz. Boy, these are really neat. I wonder who did these. No. I've had the pleasure of being part of NeoSoul Glassworks. As Liz mentioned, we're a nonprofit organization. I've had the pleasure of being part of NeoSoul now on the board for 10 years. This group started in East Walnut Hills. And about 2 years ago, we started a process of looking at where we wanted to go for purposes of growth, and frankly, a place where we could bring in our constituency, the people that want to come and learn about art glass, making it, creating it, working with it, and developing the art form. And our demographic study and our review pointed to Forest Park as a place to be. Now, Dave talked about international travel coming in. Well, let me let you know something else. For people who live in the greater Cincinnati area, this is tremendously accessible. It's great to get to, it's great to do business in, and after looking at several different places, we found our current location at the end of Kemper Springs Drive, and we've been there now about 14 or 15 months, and we couldn't be happier to be there. Thank you to all the community members, certainly council, and Paul with the Economic Development Group, that made us feel so welcome and helped us to get into our new space and get things rolling. It's been a great experience. We had our grand opening early in October of 14, and things have just been tremendous over the last 14 months. So certainly invite everyone to come out. There are classes running at NeoSoul 6 days a week where you can come in and make things like this. You can make paperweights, Christmas ornaments, Valentine's Day stuff is obviously starting to ramp up now. And we do a lot of different seasonal stuff. We're glad to be part of the community and to give back to the kids, which is something that we've done over the entire history of the organization. So we look forward to being here a long time, being an important part of the community in years to come, and hope to see everyone out there at NeoSoul in the near future. Thank you.
Because I promise, first of all, I apologize for butchering your name, NeoSoul. Tell us just a little bit about how this design came about. Was it a group of you kind of got together? Just it's kind of creative and very different.
Well, that's one of the neat things about the process. At NeoSoul, we have four to five artists on staff at any one time. And part of our mission beyond simply raising awareness is training the next generation of glass artists. Over the years, several of our artists have gone on to teach at other facilities. Two of our folks have gone on to university programs and are now running university programs, one in California and one in Wisconsin. Two other of our artists are actually out doing their own work and their own pieces. And those couple that are doing their own work outside of the academic context are actually becoming more and more successful with pieces, one in particular, sculpted figurines that are selling for high four-figure, low five-figure numbers. So we view part of our mission is to develop the art form, develop talent, and move talent through our organization out into the art world in general. So pieces like this one and other trophies that we have done and other creations that we have done for organizations around the area are really, and that's the neat thing about this art form, is it's 3D, it's tactile, you can touch it, you can see it, you can feel it, you can really experience it. And this particular design was done by kind of our lead artist at this point, as kind of a recognition of the community and you know, the development of us being part of the community. So you know, come take a look at the pieces. The gallery's open every day, the shop is open every day, and there's just some really interesting creative pieces that are out there. So you know, we hope you come take a look.
Thank you, Brian.
Thank you, Liz.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
That's really neat. Find me a great student that you're working with that we can do a story with on Channel 12, okay? Deal. He's like oblivious there. Thanks, Brian. All right, we want to move on to another business. Might be a little familiar to you because of where you're sitting today. This business, you know, I have to say, you come in, you kind of have a warm atmosphere, it's very inviting, but aside from that, they made a commitment with their partners to invest $500,000 and to acquire and renovate another vacant restaurant building and converted that to what they said had been an eyesore into this first-class sports bar and restaurant. It's an impressive renovation, wouldn't you say? And they've completed the remodeling in the kitchen and the dining areas and done a fantastic job. More than 30 TVs in here, beautiful custom design. We TV people appreciate that there's lots of TVs in here, just have to say that. It's a perfect place for your next event, breakfast, lunch, or dinner, as you can see here, sporting event. But wait, there's more. The owners aren't finished yet. They have future plans to include a sand volleyball court, a party room for 60, and even a stage area for some great music events, like some upcoming popular concerts. Blessed Union of Souls is scheduled to be here on January 30th, if you're a fan of them. Like many of the businesses in Forest Park, these are really good people dedicated to a community, and they recently started a new program called Jack's Gives Back. It's called Dine and Donate, and at night it helps school and community groups raise dollars for worthwhile causes. The restaurant also sponsors two youth sports teams as well. So ladies and gentlemen, from Jack's Tavern, please welcome its owner, Bill Asiri.
Thank you. I'm actually not the owner. I'm the general manager here. Should make sure I say that. Since you guys are in our building, I did prepare a small speech. If you guys can just give me a second here. I'm just kidding. We opened up in June. For anybody that hasn't been here yet, we did do a little bit of renovation. We own the strip across the street in this building and Starbucks as well. And when BW3's left, we decided, well, let's just do our own restaurant. And we came in, we wanted to make it a vibrant, open floor plan with TVs and the nice fire. It's supposed to be a fireplace. We're actually having trouble with the fire right now. Just part of the new business kinks that we're going through a little bit. We struggled a little bit on some ends of things, but that's how new business goes. Like she mentioned, we're getting ready to do a volleyball court. So we're always looking for new ideas and expansions. And we also cater. So if anybody needs any catering, let us know, email us. But yeah, we're excited to be part of the community. I'm actually on city council in my city where I live in, and I did that because I've been in the restaurant business for 18 years, and I was with a corporate company for 17 years and had gotten to know the mayor and the city council so much that they actually asked me to run for city council in my city where I live at. And now that we're starting a new venture up here, I'd love to get to meet everybody in the city and hopefully take the same kind of steps that I did there in my new venture here now that we're doing our own thing here. So. Yeah, just thanks for the time and thanks for coming out. And I'm the GM, so if anybody's ever in here for lunch or dinner, just grab me and let me know if you need anything, okay? Thank you.
Have to have the award in the picture. Sorry, that's the way it works. And I just want you to know, we all appreciate growing pains. Every time we launch a new news product or newscast, we actually joke that we think God puts the news on the air every day because we have so many glitches and we understand. You've done a really nice job here. Next, it's a privilege to introduce a privately minority-owned company and a leader in the electrical construction and automation field. This company can meet all of your electrical construction needs. Their team of experts installs ducts, conduits, distribution panels, and any electrical device or component that your business requires. Whether it's what they call an EMT conduit or explosion-proof installations, they have the craftsmen and the leadership to provide a professional installation. This company is also a leader in plant automation, and they design food industry batching systems, process control systems, and many other specialty systems. They offer what they call PLC and HM1 programming, or HMI, I'm not sure what that is, but I'll let them tell you, as well as communications and equipment integration. They even handle automated conveyance systems, as well as complete process and packaging turnkey systems. They recently moved to Forest Park from a neighboring community, investing more than $1 million to acquire and renovate a 12,000 square foot building in the Kemper Meadow Business Center and bring 50 new jobs to the community. Ladies and gentlemen, from ACPI Systems, please welcome the company president, Laura Meyer.
Hi. I just want to thank the City of Forest Park for welcoming us into your community. We look forward to being here for many, many years. We purchased a property which is ideal for our needs, for our growth. We have had an average of 20% growth the past 3 years, and that is one of our reasons for moving out to Forest Park. Started our business in 2000 in the basement of my home, my husband and I. And we evolved from being just a union electrical company into a specialty field of automation and integration of process control systems for the food industry. Again, I want to thank the City of Forest Park. We look forward to being here for many, many years. And the building that we purchased also has additional property. We foresee a lot of future growth, possibly another building. And thank you.
Thank you, Laura. Our next award goes to the value-added distributor of high-tech industrial automation solutions, and it sells hardware and software products to a very diverse client base that includes industrial end users. It's a world-class company, recently invested in more than $725,000 to acquire and renovate 17,000 square feet, which is in the Kemper Meadow Business Center. It has brought 25 new employees to this community. They've also been serving customers since 1956. It's a certified Wonderware software and GE PLC training provider as well. Wonderware is a global leader in what they call human-machine interface. There's that HMI. And it has real-time operations which manage software that allow management to use in the software industry. This innovative product enables production and industrial operations to synchronize business objectives to achieve speed, flexibility, and sustained profitability. Wonderware can deliver significant cost benefits for designing, building, deploying, and maintaining what they call a robust application for manufacturing and infrastructure operations. Here from ATR Distributing, please welcome the company president, Ken Schuster.
Got the last name right. One correction, I am not the president. I'm the...
this is actually all in the script. I'm not making it up.
It's okay. Just to clarify that, I'm one of the directors of the company, but not the president. He couldn't make it today. But we're moving from Cleves, Ohio. We've got a whole lot of us crammed into a really small building, and the entire team is really excited to move into Forest Park, into a much prettier building with a whole lot of room for all of us to be able to spread out a little. We are in the process controls industry, very similar to the last company that was mentioned. So it'll be great to have some neighbors around, and we've got a whole lot of other ones on the same street that are in the same arena. So that's fantastic. We hope to come over and meet you soon, see what you guys are doing. And I'd like to thank the City of Forest Park. Everybody in the building department has been great to work with. Paul has been great to work with. We're really excited to get our business started here in Forest Park. Thanks.
Thank you so much. And I, if I'm promoting people to titles, it might just be that I tell the future, just so we're clear, since I've made the owner the general manager and given you a new title. Our final award today is given to a very special group that has been and continues to be an anchor in this business community. They provide life, disability, and annuity products, as well as investment plans for individuals and families. Last year, the Lincoln, Nebraska-based company invested $17 million to reconfigure its Forest Park campus, and they built a new 70,000 square foot office and are renovating its existing building. This impressive project keeps more than 600 jobs in Forest Park. Equally impressive, the employees volunteer their time and talents for a wide range of community projects during the year. They contribute more than 20,000 hours of community service throughout the greater Cincinnati region. They've even helped many with several events here in Forest Park, including a successful classic car show to kick off the summer recreation season in the past year. Accepting the award today, I think, is the company president for its individual division. Please welcome from Emeritas, Vice President John Lucas. Sorry, Vice President John Lucas.
Thank you for the promotion, Liz. I appreciate that.
At least I'm going up.
I'm retiring in a couple of months, so this is a nice way to go out as president. I'm kidding. Thank you. Steve Hilarious was here this morning, but he had to leave for a mandatory conference call that he had to take. But he wanted me to express his wishes to the city and to the friends here today. He apologized that he couldn't be here or had to leave, but he asked me to step up, so here I am. I just want to, on behalf of the employees and the management at Emeritas, to thank the city for this award, and it's a beautiful award, beautiful award. This is pretty neat. And you know, let you know about our company. We've went through an interesting transition in the last couple of years because we built a 70,000 foot square building. We redesigned another building, and we're in the process of demolition of the original building. So there's been a lot of movement at Emeritas from a physical point of view. But what has stayed consistent is our relationship with the city of Forest Park and the relationship with the city of Forest Park with Emeritas. We are a partnership, and we've been a partnership through the old Union Central days and through the merger of Emeritas for 50 plus years. There's an old saying that you know, you're never standing still, you're either moving forward or backward. It's a law of physics, it's just the way it is about life, your business. We all know that as business people. And it's sure obvious sitting here today that the city of Forest Park is moving forward. Just extremely impressive to see the companies that are coming in and moving forward. And again, we're proud to be a part of that group because we're going to be here a while, and hopefully 100 years, as you said. And we'll have another little meeting here 100 years from now, and we'll sit here and meet and talk about the good things that are happening in the city. So again, I want to thank the city. The employees want to thank the city. The management wants to thank the city, and we're just very proud to be able to accept this very beautiful award this morning. Thank you very much.
So at least I promoted everyone up, okay? I again want to say congratulations, and before I turn the microphone back over to Paul Brehm, I just really want to give you a couple words of encouragement, because I know that when you're building a business of any kind, there is no such thing as an overnight success. And if you talk to any business owner, they'll tell you, you know, they spend 5 years sleeping on the computer room floor just to get, you know, the fireplace to work. But one of my biggest points of inspiration came from a story that we covered years ago when I was working for an affiliate that was still an ABC affiliate. And many of you may remember there was a story of a woman who gave birth to 7 babies at one time. We called them the Iowa septuplets. And at the time, there had never been 7 babies born to one woman. And after that was over, and she'd gone through so much, and there was a time where she was encouraged to abort several of the babies, and she chose not to, and she just went through so much. And she granted one interview after that, and it was to ABC News' religion reporter. And the reporter said to her, you know, how do you make it through on your hard days when, like any business owner, you just want to give up? And she said, you know, on a bad day, I have 7 crying babies, and on a good day, I have 7 smiles. But she said, you know, I get up every day, And I remember that nothing is going to happen in this day that God does not already know about. And I've never forgotten that piece of inspiration, because I know some days when you are fighting the fight to help a community and be part of the solution, you need to remember that nothing is going to happen in this day that God does not already know about. I want to thank you just for letting me be part of this each year and celebrating your success. If you like me, my name is Liz Bonus, and as Nancy alluded to, if not, it's Nancy Grace. Have a wonderful day.
Liz, if you could come back up for just a quick second. We want to thank you for joining us for our celebration today and contributing your time and talents. I did want to give you this small token of appreciation on behalf of the Chamber and the city, and thank you so much.
Tell you, this guy here, he's the real deal. I had been working with this business called Healthy Beginnings, and they'd had to close a pregnancy center in Forest Park, and they put out a blast email to all of their supporters and said, do you know anyone who would help us with our business and maybe get another place to deliver babies? And this guy, you know, has sat down and met with them and just continued to try and meet their needs. And even today he said, how can I come back and help them? So just while he stands up here and doesn't get much glory, may I say that he is the real deal. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Liz. Thank you, Liz. Before leaving, I would like to ask all of our award winners, if you have a moment, to come up and join us at the end. We would like to get some additional pictures taken very quickly. We also have boxes for all of your awards, so you can take those back with you safely. That concludes our event for today. I would like to thank once again the Forest Park City Council, the Forest Park Chamber of Commerce, our partner in today's event, the Economic Development Commission, Waycross Community Media, who has taped the program for us today, Jason and his crew, Corporate Document Solutions, who handled all of our print needs, Newsaw Glassworks for designing and creating the awards for today's event, and everybody from our city staff, Joanne Lee, Rachel Wilson, who's been taking photographs and doing everything I ask her to do for me and keeping me on track throughout the week. So thank you for everything you've done. And with that, I want to wish you all the best for the upcoming year. We look forward to seeing you again next year for the 2017 event. And once again, congratulations to our award winners. Have a good day, everybody.